Hi everyone, bonjour à tous and welcome to your French lesson of the day. Bienvenue dans la leçon du jour and today we will try to see what we call les liaisons. So let's see how it goes. So the idea of the les liaisons is that if you get a simple sentence like this one, il adore le café. Okay, so you could pronounce it like that, so each word separately like il adore le café, but then actually, usually, French people tend to make this link, like you see here, so between ILS, il, and adore, ah. So the reason for that is that adore, you can see that it's starting with a vowel, and in this case it's possible to make this small link between the S and the A. So actually liaison means link, so if you want to link the words, in this case you will get ils adorent le café. So you can see the difference between the first one, which was il adore le café, and the second one, which is ils adorent le café. Okay, so let's see now six examples. So the first one, let's pronounce it like if we didn't make the liaison first. Okay, so ils ont trois enfants. Okay, and then if we make the liaison, then you can see that it's possible to make actually two liaisons in this sentence. The first one between il and on, and the second one between trois and enfant. Okay, so we get ils ont trois enfants. Repeat. Ils ont trois enfants. Okay. Second sentence. Nous allons chez elle. Okay, so same thing, let's see how it goes if we put some liaison. Same thing here, it's possible to do two liaisons, so the first one between nous and allons, so you get nous allons, and then the second one between chez and elle, and you get chez elle. Okay, so let's read the whole sentence now together. Nous allons chez elle. Repeat. Nous allons chez elle. Okay. Third example. Quelle heure est-il? Okay. And then let's see how it goes with the liaison. So it's actually quite easy to figure because you get this trait d'union between est and il. So actually we'll have to pronounce est-il. Est-il. Okay. So the whole sentence sounds like quelle heure est-il? Alright, and then, as it's a question, it would be better to raise your voice at the end of the sentence, so it would sound like quelle heure est-il? Repeat. Quelle heure est-il? Okay. Next example. Il est 9 heures. Okay, and so with the liaison, so you can see that the liaison is coming between neuf and heure, and actually it's quite tricky in this case because we will change the sound, so we won't pronounce the F, but it would sound a bit more like V, like a V, okay? So if you make the liaison, it would sound like il est 9 heures, 9 heures. Okay, repeat. Il est 9 heures. Okay? Next example. C'est une grande famille. Okay, so let's see how it goes now. So you can see this liaison between c'est and une. Okay, so the liaison would sound like t, t. Okay, so you would get this c'est une. C'est une. Okay, and so the whole sentence. C'est une grande famille. Repeat. C'est une grande famille. Okay. And last but not least, elle peut quand elle veut. Okay, so let's see where the liaison goes, and it goes between quand and elle. Okay, and here the D would be pronounced a bit more like a T. Okay, quand elle, alright, so we get elle peut quand elle veut. Repeat. Elle peut quand elle veut. Okay, so all these examples, let's repeat them together. The first one, ils ont trois enfants. Repeat. Ils ont trois enfants. Second one, nous allons chez elle. Repeat. Nous allons chez elle. Numéro 3. Quelle heure est-il? Repeat. Quelle heure est-il? OK. Numéro 4. Il est 9 heures. Il est 9 heures. Repeat. Il est 9 heures. OK. Numéro 5. C'est une grande famille. Repeat. C'est une grande famille. OK. Numéro 6. Elle peut quand elle veut. Repeat. Elle peut quand elle veut. OK. I do hope it was clear for you. Bye bye and see you soon.